I'm a witch.
Okay. You a good witch or a bad witch?
Comme ci, comme ça.
Come on, bad guy!
Little boy!
Little boy, here now.
I don't mean to be disrespectful, but we want to live normal lives.
What is normal to you, young man, is to us asinine.
Hello, Digby. Did you have a nice day?
Would you mind flying down from your roost?
My, we are testy today, aren't we?
You're a card.
Oh, it's nice of you to say so. Tell me more about yourself.
Well, I...
Kind of bat, Mother, a baseball bat.
I'm afraid you've lost me.
It's a game that people play. Haven't you ever seen it?
Oh, don't be absurd, Samantha.
Well, it's very exciting. They play it with a ball and a big stick called a bat. One man throws it to the man holding the bat who tries to hit it. Then everybody chases the ball, and the man who hits it runs around in a circle on a field called a diamond before anyone else can tag him.
You're not serious.
Oh, yes, Darren took me once.
I don't believe it.
And the one who runs around the most wins the series.
Series of what?
Nothing. Just a series.
It's typical. Typical. That's a human being for you. Spend most of their lives running around in circles for a series of nothing.
Toast, why don't you pour the coffee?
Oh, certainly.
Shucks, I guess you'll just have to pour it by hand.
Oh, it's heavy. Oh.
You're wondering why I came in with a baby.
No.
Edgar is Edna's child. Edna's my sister. Edgar was born the very same week as Tabitha. Oh, but they're completely different.
How nice, considering he's a boy.
Oh, no, I mean really different.
Well, I wouldn't be surprised.
Edgar's much more advanced. Aren't you? Aren't you, you little Einstein, you... You see, my sister's husband is a CPA.
Right. My imagination's been playing tricks on me. But I'm delighted it was me instead of a real battle between you two.
Oh, don't give it another thought, Mrs. Stevens.
She must be tired after her long journey. Poor dear.
Mother.
Hello, darling. That's Darren's banana.
How was I to know? It was just floating by.
It's on its way upstairs.
Mother, I want to talk to you.
Did you find the book you were looking for, darling?
No, but I found something else.
What's that?
My husband.
Well, darling, you can't win them all.
At least.
For your information, I was about to enter my bath.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Dr. Bombay, but this is something of an emergency.
You know perfectly well my practice is limited to our own people.
But I thought just this teensy-weensy once you'd make an exception. Mm-hmm. For me? Pretty please.
And Dora, some women can get away with being coy. You are not among their number.
You're my daughter. He's my son-in-law. I love him very, very, very much.
Don't be a hypocrite. You didn't love him before. Why would you love him now?
He needs me. He also needs something to go out and play in.
Oh, that's adorable.
Come on, precious. Try it on.
Mind if you believe that. I think I'll make him a pork loin.
Wouldn't it be much more fun if you turned him into a whole pig?
No wonder there's no such thing as Mother-in-Law's Day. What do you make, Mr. Callahan?
Well, this will kill you. Perfume. Ain't that a gas? Look, here's a sample. For you, Bright Eyes, we just came out with it.
Autumn Flame.
Yeah, for the older babes, you know?
He means for the more mature woman.
Oh, have it your way. You're the advertising man. You see, the way I figure it, why should just the young chicks get all the attention? I mean, an old babe like you's got a right to smell nice too.
Yes, Tabitha and I spent a perfectly lovely day there last week.
Oh, you did. How nice.
They were there for half an hour, and I was with them.
Tabitha just loved the unicorn and the dodo bird.
There are no such things as unicorns and dodo birds.
We saw the usual things. Elephants and tigers and monkeys.
And a unicorn. And a dodo bird.
The meals and things like that.
Samantha, you mean to say that you're paying someone to do what you could do with a snap of your fingers? Oh, how utterly, utterly immortal.
It's Mrs. Stevens' idea.
Oh, so Durwood's mommy wanted you to have a maid. Oh, how sweet.
Called the material.
Oh, it's a worsted.
I don't want your worsted. I want your bastard.
That's funny, sir. Will this be cash or charge?
Oh, not so.
Hi.
Hi. Moms.
I'm here to enjoy our newfound friendship.
Well, care to make me a sandwich? Endora, I asked you to make me a sandwich.
Make it yourself, Durwood.
Durwood?
Make it yourself and then choke on it.
Endora, would you?
Here, right over here, this little girl right here.
Mother!
Hello.
Ha ha.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. How nice. Here you are, darling.
Can Grandmama have a cookie, too?
They're not by chance from an Alice B. Toklas recipe.
They're my recipe.
Then I think I'll pass.
Trick or treat?
Don't push me, little boy.
Aren't you going to give us anything?
More than you bargained for if you don't run along, little fellow.
Then we're going to have to trick you.
I'm ready if you are.
Abracadabra, you're a tree. Then let's get out of here.
Probably be there. Oh, that was a marvelous costume.
Yours too, Endora.
I beg your pardon.
That bizarre outfit you're wearing. Oh, and that hairdo.
Jack, your car's waiting.
You were saying, Mr. Rogers?
Oh, that's a great outfit you're wearing. You must have won first prize.
Now, why don't you help me with the dishes?
Costume, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Good night, Jack.
Good night, Darren. Good night, Darren.
Happy Halloween.
Poor Belle. I'm Miss Gravestrod. I write the fashion copy for Tate McMahon. I've seen your picture a million times. Now, I just want to get a little advance on what you're planning for next season. Are we through with those long skirts the girls have been wearing? I do hope so. They're so dreary. Don't you agree?
I may be violently ill.
Mother?
Hmm.
You know very well you catch more flies with honey than with vinegar.
Tell that to the Dodger outfield.
It's the only way to fly.